I work with a team of media professionals and we call ourselves Take One. We tell stories through films. During the COVID-19 pandemic, churches, schools, and institutes, organizations all over the world woke up to this need, to this real need to reach out and also to communicate. What happened as a result was a lot of pastors, young people, teachers found themselves creating content. And today I want to address you young people as not just active users of the media, but also as content creators. In 2017, we made a documentary called The Pangti Story, and it all started with curiosity. A village, a Naga village, had stopped hunting and they had all become protectors. So I was personally very curious as to how it was possible, you know, how the situation was possible for a Naga village. We never expected it to go places, but the film traveled to many festivals and also won awards. One personal takeaway for me from this experience was the power of storytelling, that when we tell stories, people are listening. There's an audience willing to engage with us, and therefore, as storytellers, we have a huge responsibility. Over the last few years, we've also had the opportunity to explore different kinds of topics and themes, including HIV/AIDS and also abuse, sexual abuse. When these subjects share their stories with us, it's because they trust us, and we become guardians of their stories. And therefore, as storytellers, we must deal with not just our subjects, but our stories with empathy and compassion, and not just conveniently take it in any direction that we want. You young people, you are from the digital age. You've grown up with smartphones. You can take good photographs. You can even edit videos. For the traditional media like radio, television, or print media, that was not the case. There were people who were trained specifically for every role. And therefore, content was also much controlled and there was accountability. Unfortunately, we don't see that with social media. With social media, there are just too many voices and also a tendency for a lot of noise. I myself am from a media background, and as much as I am in awe of social media, it also makes me wary sometimes because for a lot of us, and especially young people, it is the first thing we wake up to and also the last thing we hold before going to sleep. There are three things I want to leave with you. Firstly, let us be responsible users. When any kind of content reaches you, please pause and think before forwarding it. Secondly, let us be accountable creators. You know, we have to be accountable for any kind of content that we are creating. Thirdly, can you be positive? When you post any comment online, please remember that at the receiving end is a human being. I believe that it's important for us not just to be active users, but to be conscious users. I want to urge you all to not just be active users of the media, but be conscious users. Conscious using of the media can lead to meaningful conversations, can bridge gaps, and can really make a difference. Thank you for listening.